Now, HubSpot is split up into various products. The one I want to show you today is a CRM. So the CRM is a customer relationship management tool. How this can help you is it will allow for you to pretty much keep track of your contacts. Right here, you have a contacts link. You have, of course, the dashboard, which we're looking at. One of the first things you'll want to do is import some contacts. So you can do that with an Excel file through your dashboard. The other thing that is neat is once you get some contacts in here, which you can add manually, off the screen to the right, there is a button for adding a contact. You'll see that when you get in there. And you can just go ahead and put the email and their first and last name in there. Right now we've got a sample contact. So let's just open up that record and have a look at what your options are. The reason why I want to share this value with you is so that you have a repository for all of your contacts. You may already be using a certain tool, and that's great. But I wanted to make sure you knew about this because it's a free tool and promises to always be free. They have these other products. One of their, well, their main product is their marketing automation product. So that's where you would send out emails and so forth to your mailing list. But a neat thing about this tool here is you see that there's an email icon in the contact record. So if you click email, you have this sample contact here. You see that you can easily drop a quick email to a one-off contact of yours, and that brings some great personal value. I think we would all agree. So, since this is a short introduction to the tool, wanted to just make you aware of it. Get in there, roll your sleeves up a little bit. It's a free product. Import some contacts or create manually some contacts once you're inside. And just hit the ground running like that and see how it works for you. Definitely a great tool to use. You can use this along with some of the other mailing list services such as AWeber and MailChimp, things like that. In the meantime, like I said, go ahead and play with this tool. Perhaps put it into play for your own business so that you have a place to keep your contacts and a way that you can easily reach them and track different types of activities and so forth. Recently, we looked at HubSpot CRM for managing your contacts. Today, we're going to look at the same tool, but this time we're going to look at how you can add a task to a contact record or for yourself. So all you need to do in order to do that is click on Tasks, and you can click on Add a Task. Right here, we can just say, okay, today I want to touch base with Brian, and we have a due date. We can put a time in there, say 2:15, and then we can choose a contact down here if we want. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and type in Brian's name. Let's click on that and then save it. Now we have a task listed. Up here to the top left, you can see that there are different views. So if I click on board, we'll see that I have a board where I can move my tasks through these various stages: in progress, waiting, completed, deferred. All right, and then on the far left as well, we have a table option. So this is just a different view, a table view. And we can line up our tasks like this. Let's go back to the agenda view just to show you that this has a check mark option. So if you click on the check mark, like a little to-do list, it'll draw a line through that. So let's look at a few more things. If you wanted to add a task to a contact record, click on Contacts at the top left here in the menu bar. This will bring up our list of contacts. Here I have my sample contact. Let's click on Brian's record and drill into this. Up at the top, we have Create a Task. Let's click on that. Go ahead and you would type in your task here. Click Save. And that's another way to add a task for yourself. Now, let's go back once more to tasks and look at the views here. At the middle, we have the board view. Here's the task that we just added. What's cool about this is you see that you have different stages, and you can left click and drag that and keep track of your tasks this way. So keep this in mind as you're managing your different contacts with your different tasks. And this is a quick, free, easy tool for you to use. Now, HubSpot is split up into various products. The one I want to show you today is a CRM. So the CRM is a customer relationship management tool. How this can help you is it will allow for you to pretty much keep track of your contacts. Right here, you have a contacts link. You have, of course, the dashboard, which we're looking at. One of the first things you'll want to do is import some contacts. So you can do that with an Excel file through your dashboard. The other thing that is neat is once you get some contacts in here, which you can add manually, off the screen to the right, there is a button for adding a contact. You'll see that when you get in there. And you can just go ahead and put the email and their first and last name in there. Right now we've got a sample contact. So let's just open up that record and have a look at what your options are. The reason why I want to share this value with you is so that you have a repository for all of your contacts. You may already be using a certain tool, and that's great, but I wanted to make sure you knew about this because it's a free tool and promises to always be free. They have these other products. One of their Well, their main product is their marketing automation product. So that's where you would send out emails and so forth to your mailing list. But a neat thing about this tool here is you see that there's an email icon in the contact record. So if you click email, you have this sample contact here. You see that you can easily drop a quick email to a one-off contact of yours. And that brings some great personal value. I think we would all agree. So since this is a short introduction to the tool, wanted to just make you aware of it. Get in there, roll your sleeves up a little bit. It's a free product. Import some contacts or create manually some contacts once you're inside. And just hit the ground running like that and see how it works for you. Definitely a great tool to use. You can use this along with some of the other mailing list services such as AWeber and MailChimp, things like that. In the meantime, like I said, go ahead and play with this tool, perhaps put it into play for your own business so that you have a place to keep your contacts and a way that you can easily reach them and track different types of activities and so forth. Recently, we looked at HubSpot CRM for managing your contacts. Today, we're going to look at the same tool, but this time we're going to look at how you can add a task to a contact record or for yourself. So all you need to do in order to do that is click on tasks, and you can click on add a task. Right here, we can just say, okay, today I want to touch base with Brian, and we have a due date. We can put a time in there, say 2:15. And then we can choose a contact down here if we want. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and type in Brian's name. Let's click on that and then save it. Now we have a task listed. Up here to the top left, you can see that there are different views. So if I click on board, we'll see that I have a board where I can move my tasks through these various stages: in progress, waiting, completed, deferred. All right, and then on the far left as well, we have a table option. So this is just a different view, a table view. and we can line up our tasks like this. Let's go back to the agenda view just to show you that this has a checkmark option. So if you click on the checkmark, like a little to-do list, it'll draw a line through that. So let's look at a few more things. If you wanted to add a task to a contact record, click on Contacts at the top left here in the menu bar. This will bring up our list of contacts. Here I have my sample contact. Let's click on Brian's record and drill into this. Up at the top, we have Create a Task. Let's click on that. Go ahead and you would type in your task here. Click Save. And that's another way to add a task for yourself. Now, let's go back once more to tasks and look at the views here. At the middle, we have the board view. Here's the task that we just added. What's cool about this is you see that you have different stages, and you can left click and drag that and keep track of your tasks this way. So keep this in mind as you're managing your different contacts with your different tasks. And this is a quick, free, easy tool for you to use.